Hello, good morning everyone, and welcome to Gangotri International School. It is a new school at Gondal City, Gangotri International School, and let me introduce you with the academic model, that is our E3 system, our academic model. I would call my friend to explain you the academic model, that is the E3 system. Please go.
Hello everyone, as my friend already told about our academic model, so now the question is, what basically our academic model? Our academic model with E3 system. Now the question is, what E stands for actually? And why 3 over there? Yes, E stands for EDUCATEE, exposure and expand. Now what we are going to expose and what we are going to expand? Well, we are going to expand their reading, listening, writing and speaking skill. Now the question is, how you are going to expand that 4 basic skills? Because every educator or every student requires these 4 basic skills. Okay, now I am going to discuss our model with our practical teaching only, how we are implementing this thing in our methodology or in our teaching. So in center, we are having our educator or our students. They are learning all these subjects. I am giving you an example of English subject, particularly English grammar, how they expand their skill. The first thing is, they know something. They know something like, they know this word, position. I ask my kids to read this and they used to say, yes ma'am, this is position, I know that. I used to add this one more and I ask them, now what is that? And they are saying, ma'am, that is preposition, we have heard somewhere. It means they know something. They have learned somewhere, yeah, in their previous class, preposition. Now the question arises, I ask them what's preposition. Few of my kids answer, ma'am, preposition is, it tells something about now. Okay, then I used to hide this thing and I used to say to them, now read this thing again. They say position. And I ask meaning, what's mean by position? They used to say that, ma'am, position is actually a place. Yes, definitely. The preposition also tells the position of noun and pronoun. So, they know something and we have added something by saying that the position of noun and pronoun. Now, they want to observe that. Matlab, to gain uska knowledge badhane ke liye, agar wo dekhte hai, they stick, agar usko dimaag mein kuch stick karwana hai, so definitely they have to observe something. So, practically, how we are teaching the preposition, and they say, if I take one pen and I ask my students, that where is the pen actually? And they give me answer, pen is on the table. Yes. So, pen, noun, on the table, preposition. Yani pen ki position batai, that is preposition. So, after knowing that particular word, they observe that thing and they implement. Later on, we are having certain activities where full whole class, some class mein baithte hai aur ek kid jo usko hum bahar baithte hai, dusre bacche hide and seek kind of, ke bacche ki space safal ho jati hai, jab bacha andar aata hai, we used to ask where that kid is, aur wo bolta hai sitting in between. So they are implementing and after doing these 3 things, they share with their friends, they share with their other teachers, they share with their parents. So this way they expand their skills. If I force my kid to read this thing, if I force my kid to read preposition every day, they are not going to read it. But unknowingly they get expand of their 4 basic skills. This is how we are teaching them. This is how our academic model works. Now the question is, this is all about English. What about other subjects? So I would like to request my friend who is teaching science over here. So I request her to explain her methodology or explain how she teach science with this system.
Already got a very good example of English. Ke English mein ye system jo hai wo hum class mein kis tarike se padhate, you already got an example. Now let me tell you a simple example of science or social science jo abhi recently main class mein gayi thi to hua tha, that I wanted to teach the subject science and in that the topic was solar system. So solar system mein is tarike se tha ki I thought ki kuch naya karte hain, to main globe leke gayi bachcho ke paas. सोलर सिस्टम में उसका जो था वो एक बार घर से रिवाइज करके गए कि सोलर सिस्टम है, गैलेक्सीज है, मीटियोरॉइड्स है, तो एक ग्लोब लेके गए डूइंग समथिंग. तो पहले तो वो नो को क्लियर करना था मुझे दैट उन्हें जो पता है वो सही पता है या नहीं. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट आई डिड इज आई जस्ट गेव देम द नॉलेज दैट वी आर नॉट एक्चुअली लिविंग इनसाइड द अर्थ, वी आर लिविंग ऑन द अर्थ. नाउ द स्टूडेंट्स वर लाइक क्वेश्चन मार्क दैट मैम हम अगर ऊपर रहते तो हम गिर नहीं जाते, उड़ते नहीं है. नो, सो व्हाट हैपेंड, आई हैड टू टीच देम ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एट दैट पॉइंट इटसेल्फ. It was not in the syllabus also, but I had to teach them gravitational force. So what I did is, whatever they were knowing, I expanded their knowledge by telling them gravitational force. But they were not able to understand what is gravitational force. So what we did is, I made them observe. With a small activity, I asked few kids to go out of the class ke bahar jaake, darwaze ko pakad ke rakhne ke liye bola, aur do teen bachcho ko bola ki aap darwaza khinch ke dekho. तो दरवाजा जब खींच रहे थे बच्चे तो वो खुल ही नहीं रहा था. तो मैम कुछ है बाहर जो हमें खींच के रख रहा है, हम नहीं खोल पा रहे. यस आई टोल्ड द स्टूडेंट्स दैट इज व्हाट ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इज, जो अर्थ के अंदर ही है ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स जो हमें खींच के रखता है, जिसकी वजह से ना हम गिरते हैं ना हम फ्लोट करते, उड़ते भी नहीं है. तो दैट इज ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स. एंड उनको वो भी पता था कि मैम हमें पता है, हमने कहीं पे देखा है कि मून के ऊपर लोग उठते हैं. यस, क्यों उठते हैं मून के ऊपर? बिकॉज वहां पे ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स नहीं है. तो वो दोनों चीजों को कनेक्ट करके उनको ऑब्जर्व कर रहे हैं. देन द स्टूडेंट स्टार्टेड इम्प्लीमेंटिंग इट इन एवरीथिंग. दे स्टार्टेड इम्प्लीमेंटिंग दैट यस, देखो हम भी नहीं गिर रहे हैं. अगर हम पेन को भी गिरा रहे हैं नीचे तो वो पेन डायरेक्टली नीचे ही आ रही है. दैट मीन्स देयर इज ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स जो हमें सबको नीचे की तरफ खींच रही है. एंड फाइनली व्हाट दे डिड इज दे शेयर्ड देयर व्यूज. नाउ दे हैड कम टू नो समथिंग न्यू, उन्हें कुछ नया सीखने के लिए मिला था. जो ऑलरेडी वो सोच रहे थे कि ऐसा है वैसा नहीं था, और उन्हें कुछ नया सीखने मिला. तो उन्होंने अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ, फैमिली के साथ, पेरेंट्स के साथ शेयर किया. एंड फाइनली उन्होंने सीखा दैट वी आर नॉट लिविंग इनसाइड द अर्थ, वी आर लिविंग ऑन द अर्थ. एंड इवन दे आर कनेक्टिंग विथ इंग्लिश ऑल्सो दैट यस मैम टुडे वी हैव लर्न प्रेपोजिशन. तो प्रेपोजिशन के साथ ही कनेक्ट हो सकता है दैट इन एंड ऑन में क्या फर्क है. एंड इन दैट वे दे लर्न अ सिंपल टॉपिक इन दिस फोर वेज. एंड ऑटोमेटिकली उनकी सारी स्किल्स डेवलप हो गई. जो LSRW स्किल्स है वो ऑटोमेटिकली डेवलप हो गई. मुझे उनको बोलना नहीं पड़ा दैट यू रीड, मुझे ना बोलना पड़ा दैट यू स्पीक, राइट और लिसन, बिकॉज इट वॉज वेरी मच इंटरेस्टिंग. सो ऑल द स्किल्स डेवलप बाय देयर ओन. सो दिस इज द वे हाउ वी टीच द स्टूडेंट्स द एकेडमिक मॉडल. दिस इज द वे हाउ वी टीच द स्टूडेंट्स इन द क्लास प्रैक्टिकली. सो For more details, you can subscribe our channel, Gangotri International School. Also, you can visit our www.gisgondal.com. Also, we are having our application on Play Store with the name Gangotri International School. For more details, you can log into that and you can watch the videos. Thank you.